It's a dream deal for Iran and a nightmare for the world. That's how Benjamin Netanyahu describes the nuclear deal with Iran. But President Obama says it's a good plan. Well, now he's got to sell that good plan to Congress.
The president may have a very tough job on his hands, as many in Congress and other countries are already very skeptical about this plan. Dale Hurd has the story.
President Obama is defending the Iran deal as a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity, telling the New York Times, this is our best bet by far to make sure Iran doesn't get a nuclear weapon. The agreement includes what the White House says would be unprecedented inspections and monitoring of Iran's nuclear facilities for at least 20 years. It would mean Iran will have to roll back its nuclear programs, dismantle equipment, and make sure major plants are only for civilian use. And in exchange, economic sanctions against Iran would be lifted over time. But there's a problem. The deal being described by Washington is not the deal being described by Iran. In fact, Iran has formally complained that the agreement the White House is selling to the world is not what was actually accepted by Iran in the talks. And Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu warns that the deal threatens the survival of Israel. He says he's not opposed to a deal with Iran, but is opposed to a plan that leaves its nuclear program in place and gives it a path to a nuclear bomb.
I'm not trying to kill any deal. I'm trying to kill a bad deal. And you say it's a historic decision, a historic deal. It could be a historically bad deal because it leaves the preeminent terrorist state of our time with a vast nuclear infrastructure. Remember, not one centrifuge is destroyed. Thousands of centrifuges will be left spinning uranium.
Meanwhile, the White House has already begun an aggressive campaign to sell the deal to a skeptical Congress.
Many, many details are unknown at this point, and so I don't know how anyone could really ascertain whether this is something good or bad yet for the American citizenry.
Until they stop their provocative behavior, I think we'd be nuts to give them more money and more capability.
President Obama has vowed that Iran will not get a nuclear weapon on his watch. But Arab allies fear the White House deal will destabilize the region, creating a nuclear arms race. The White House says a so-called international mechanism will verify that Tehran doesn't cheat on the agreement, and that cannot be reassuring to Congress. Both sides will now work to finalize the agreement by the end of June. Dale Hurd, CBN News.
You know, years and years ago, we ended World War II as the victors, and then our president sat down with Joseph Stalin, and he said, you know, I'm a gentleman, and I'm going to deal with Joe Stalin as a gentleman, and so we will give him things that show what our good faith is. Well, Stalin just laughed at him. He was a tough old-line Bolshevik, and he thought this white shoe president was a joke. And he took him for everything he could. And in the process, millions of people were under the heel of communist domination. And Roosevelt gave away a large slice of Europe. Well, Obama's the same mindset. We're going to be so nice to these people that they're going to come to the table and they're going to be nice to us. These are radical Muslims who have a Muslim theocracy that suppresses the rights of their own people. And they have been the prime agents of terror around the world. And now they've just taken over Yemen. They've got their hands on Lebanon. They've got Syria. They've got Iraq. I mean, what more is he going to give them? Well, he's going to give them a lot of money. And they are the man who made the negotiation for Iran, is being hailed as a hero. And Obama and Kerry is saying, oh, no, these sanctions are going to be phased out over time. And the guy from Iran has said, no, right now sanctions are lifted. And billions of dollars will be flowing into the Iranian treasury. And what are they going to do with them? Build bombs, fund more terrorism, and go after what they themselves call the great Satan. Would you like to sit across the table and negotiate with somebody who thinks you are Satan? What kind of a nutty deal is this? Well, President Obama is hey, by the way, the president, one way of getting rid of his critics, he brings a lawsuit against them. So he's going to indict Senator Menendez, who was against this deal in favor of Israel. He'll get him indicted, and that he'll be facing criminal charges for alleged violations.